Hi, I'm Dana. Welcome to rainydayguitar.com. Okay, today I'm going to show you how to play House on Pooh Corner by Kenny Loggins, one of my favorite songs, also at the top of my level, so I'll be making some mistakes, just gotta go with that. But anyway, it's a really cool version. It's not exactly what he does, but it's very close. I learned it a slightly different way years and years ago, so I'm gonna share that with you. It's kind of a combo of what he does plus what I learned, but it's a really neat arrangement. You can go to rainydayguitar.com, you can print it off. This one takes 2 pages, but I've got the chords on there and some hints and all kinds of fun things for you so you can play this most amazing, wonderful song. Okay, I'm gonna put it on and play it with him once, and then I will go back and I will show you step by step how to play this, because there's a lot to this song. It's probably one of the hardest songs I know. Okay, I'm probably gonna miss the beginning just because I can't get back there and fast enough. So let me get my hands in the right place. Maybe I can join them. Okay, here we go. Missed it already. I can do this. gonna show you how to do that. Hopefully I won't mess up, well I won't, if I go slower. Anyway, all right, this guy's driving me crazy. Okay, so let me go ahead and show you the beginning. So what you're gonna do is you're going to, and this one, it really does help to have the words. You can go to readydayguitar.com, you can print off both pages for, and follow along with the chords and everything. Okay, we're gonna start off, we're gonna put our pointer on the second string, fourth fret, and our tall man on the third string, fifth fret, and we're gonna pluck two and three together, okay? And you're gonna slide up one fret, okay? And then you're gonna hit one, which is the same note as two now. Okay, so two and three, slide, then hit one. Okay, then slide to the fourth fret, both fingers in the fourth fret, and then the second fret, let's see, there's one in there. Not till you get after that second. So you're going to go fourth fret, second fret, then hit one. And then you're going to go pointer finger on the third string, first fret, hit those guys again, two and three, and then hit one. Okay, so let's take it that far. Okay, second, third string, fourth and fifth fret. Fourth, second, one, first fret, one. Okay, and then you're going to go to the second string, third string, second fret, and fourth string, fourth fret, and pluck those two guys together, three and four, then one, slide up two frets, now you're on four and six, pluck those two again, then hit one, slide all the way down to the bottom, so first fret and second fret, and then go, so then pluck that, pause, two, one, two. Okay, so let's do that much, okay? So you're gonna go, I'll talk you through it. Okay, second, third, here we go. So pluck second, third, slide, one, fourth, second, one, and pointer on the third string, first fret, one. Now you're jumping to the fourth and third string, second, fourth fret. So pluck four and three, one, slide up two frets, pluck, one, slide all the way down to the bottom, pluck, pause, two, one, two. Okay, should we try that a little faster? Here we go. Sorry, okay, try it again. Okay, I'm gonna use my right fingers. Fourth, pause, two, now you're going to jump to the fifth and the fourth string on the second fourth fret. Pluck those guys. Now I'm going to bring in my thumb just because it gets a little awkward, because I'm going to pluck with my thumb and my pointer. Up until now I've been using these guys, okay? I'm going to go pluck these guys, one, so four and five, pluck, slide up two frets, and then, so now, let's see, let me tell you the fret numbers. I'm on the fourth and fifth string, okay? So second fret and fourth fret, one, slide up to four and six, oops, don't pluck that guy, pluck four and five, and then now I'm on six and seven. So you're gonna go four and six, six and seven, one. And there's no one in between those, so you're gonna go, again, two and four, one, four and six, six and seven, one. Now take your pointer and drop only your pointer down a string to the fourth string and slide. Well, I gotta make sure I'm right. Yeah, so now you're gonna be on to four and six. Ring is now on fifth string, sixth fret, and pointer is on the third string, fourth fret. Pluck five and three. Five and three, and I don't think there's a one in between. See. Oh yeah, there is. Okay, so five and three, one, then down to two and four, pause. Two, one, two, five, three, two, one. That's the pattern I like. He does it a little bit different, but then I end up, and I don't have enough time to get back up to where I need to go, so I've kind of rearranged it a little bit for me to make it easier. So that, on this last string, you're gonna go, five and three, pause, two, one, two, five, three, two, one. And then you can take your hand off because one is open anyway, okay? And then you go back up and you do it again, but let's kind of walk through that and then I'll put the ending on for you. Okay, back to, let's go back to just this part. Okay, so this is kind of the second half. Okay, so we're on the five and fifth and fourth string on the second and fourth fret. So plucking two, I'm gonna tell the fret numbers. Two and four, first string, four and six, six and seven, first string, switch strings, drop down to the third and fifth string now, and you're on four and six, one, drop down to two and four, pause, two, one, two, five, three, two, one. Okay, let's try that a little faster. Here we go. I won't be able to say it and do it. I'm just going to do it slow. Here we go. Let's put that whole thing together with the beginning. This is still the intro, but so cool. Okay, here we go. Okay, so we're starting with two and three. No, don't do a double. Okay, I always have to warm up. I don't know why. Okay. So that's why, then I sound stupid. Okay, try it again. Faster. I'm not sure I can go a whole lot faster. This part I learned recently. The other part I learned years and years ago. I've got that kind of to memory, but this part I'm still working on. Okay, here we go. One more time, a little bit faster. Okay, let's try it again. Come on, you can do this. Yeah, it works better to grab, not with your thumb. Oh, I switched to my thumb. Repeat only the first part. And then you grab, this is an E suspended fourth, so you're going to go five, four, and three, fifth, fourth, and third strings on the second fret, and you're going to go strum, strum, up, down. So you're going to kind of go down, down, up, down. Okay, let's put that whole intro together. Okay, here we go. Whew, okay, deep breath. Okay, I won't go too fast. Ah, just a note. Oh. Pretend I didn't do that stupid note of the tune. Okay, one more time for me. Here we go. I'll go a little faster. You're getting the gist of this. Okay, now the part that I'm better at. Okay, we're going to start the song. So we're going to do I've called this an E major seventh, which I think I'm right. We're going to go third and fourth string on the first fret. Okay, so that doesn't sound very good, but that's all we need. I guess you'd have to go, that's a true E major seventh, but we don't need our fifth string because we're not going to play them. So we're going to go third, fourth string, first fret, six. I'm going to tell you, I'm going to go into the middle. And by that, usually my thumb is assigned to six, five, and four. Pointer three, tall man two, and ring one. That's my standard finger assignment. So when I say go into the middle, I mean take off of one, two, three, and slide everybody up and go two, three, four. That is what we're going to do for the majority of this song. So if I'm talking about out of the middle and into the middle, that's what I mean. Into the middle is 2, 3, 4, and out of the middle is 1, 2, 3. Okay, we're going to go into the middle. Here we go. We're going to go 6, 3, twins. And I'm going to call twins whatever things, strings I'm plucking at the same time. Right now it's 2 and 3. So usually it's 1 and 2, but since we're in the middle, it's now 2 and 3. So we're going to go 6, 3, twins, 3. Okay, or it's not three, huh, it's four, because we're in the middle. Six, four, twins, four, sorry about that. Bar the second fret, that's technically enough, sharp minor seventh, if you care. And then it's a six, four, twins, four, up to the fourth fret, six, four, twins, four, now a C sharp minor, five, and we're gonna go out of the middle, five, three, twins, three, okay? If you don't know C sharp minor seventh. It's like a B minor, but up two frets. This is not a song for beginners. I'm hoping you know your chords, okay? And but these even have some weird names to them. Okay, so this is a true C sharp minor though. It's on the fourth fret, barring the fourth fret. Now I'm gonna leave these fingers there and I'm gonna reach over and grab six on the fifth fret, right on that dot that I see on top of my guitar. And I'm gonna go six, I'm gonna go back into the middle, and this is technically an A major seventh, which if you see an A major seventh, it's the same thing, I'm just up high. Okay, so it's an A major seventh up high, and I'm gonna go six, four, twins, four. I'm gonna slide all the way up, I'm gonna bar the seventh fret, ring finger on the third string, eighth fret, stay in the middle. That's a B7th, okay? It's a B7th, but it's a high B7th, okay? Bass 3, bass 4, twins 4, which is 6. And then I'm gonna go, I'm gonna do this. Okay? So I'm gonna go on the 12th fret, ring finger on the first string, pointer on the 11th fret, 5th string. I'm gonna pluck 5 and 1. Slide everybody down to the 7th fret, 5 and 1, slide down to the 4th fret and the 5th fret. Pointer is on the 4th fret, 5th string, and ring is on the 1st string, 5th fret. Pluck 5 and 1 and then spread them out, and now I'm on 2nd fret, 5th, same strings, 5th string and 1st string on the 4th fret. So let me show you that. Again, so this is, I'm going to say the fret numbers. I'm always on the fifth and the first string, okay? So 11 and 12, both on seventh, five and four, and then four and two. Okay, a little faster. Oh, come on, I can do this. There we go. Okay, so now let's put that whole first part together because that comes up many times in the song. So we're gonna start again. We're gonna go six in the middle. This is the E minor, major seventh, so third and fourth string, first fret. Do it again. Six, three, twins, three, or sorry, six, four, twins, four. Bar the second fret, do it again. Six, four, twins, four. Fourth fret, six, four, twins, four. Drop down to a C sharp minor. Out of the middle, so up on the first string. Reach over with your pointer, grab the dot, the sixth string, this is your A major seventh. Slide up, bar the seventh fret, and put your ring finger on the third string, eighth fret, staying still in the middle. Now do your walk down. Oh, hello. Come on, don't slide off my guitar. Okay, I'm gonna put the words with that so you can kind of see how that goes, okay? And then we're gonna repeat it. Almost, all the way through. Christopher Robin and I walked along under branches lit up by the moon. Keep going. Posing the questions to do it, Alan Dior. What am I doing? For as our days disappeared, all to. Going to do something different. We're going to bar, still barring the seventh fret, but we're not going to worry about six anymore. We're going to pull it down and we're going to do a high E major seventh, which is the same chord as this bottom one down here, but just up higher. Okay, so what that is we're on the seventh fret. We were there, right? But we're just going to make sure our tall man's now holding down the third string, eighth fret. Still barring on the seventh. Take our ring, put him up on the fourth string, and our pinky on the second string on the ninth fret. Both of these two guys are on the ninth. And we're gonna go. So that was bass three, twins three, bass one, two, three. Okay? So let me play that second part for you. So Christopher Robin, I worked along, and her branches lit up by the moon. So we just did moon. Whoops. Moon. Drop back down to a C sharp minor, fourth fret, same position as a B minor, but up on the fourth. Wandered much further to, and I like like that same pick, so I'm going to go bass, three, twins, three, bass, and you can even hit four there. Five, three, twins, three, four, one, two, three. That's kind of pretty. So I wandered much further to. Now give me a whole bar four. Fourth fret. David, I should. David. Yeah, I like to go into the middle there. Go into the middle and go bass. So six, four, twins, four. No, you can't hit five. Six, four, twins, four, six, two, three, four. Same pick as you did. So one, so you go like this. Wandered much further today than I should, and I. Good. Now we're going to do that funky chord, which is an A major seventh. So we went from here, and we're going to go to kind of back to our C sharp minor, but instead we're going to let go of the bar and just hold down that sixth string fifth fret. And I can't seem to find my way. Same pick, but in the middle. Six, four, twins, four, six, two, three, four. Can't seem to find my way. Now we're going to drop down to an F sharp seventh. Do a full F sharp there. You could do an F sharp 7. I'm just not that talented. What all that is it's an F up one fret. Take off, my pinky gets locked. And take off your pinky, and that's an F sharp 7. To make it just a true F sharp, just put your pinky on. That's the only difference, okay? Can't seem to find my way back to the. Going to slide all the way up to that B7th on the 7th fret, same one that we had before with our ring on the, or tall man, whoever, on the 3rd string 8th fret. Would so, and we're in the middle, bass 6, 4, twins 4, okay? So let's put that whole C sharp minor little sequence together. So I wandered much further today than I should, and I can't seem to. That F sharp seventh. I still missed it. So, my hand's killing me. Okay. Oh, I just noticed a mistake. There's a space where there shouldn't be a space. Okay, so I'll fix that. Make a little note so I don't forget before I post this. Just one second. That somehow randomly got a space in there. Okay, so now we're gonna go back to the beginning. So, third and fourth fret. No, third and fourth string, first fret. Same thing, into the middle, bass three, twins three. So, help me, bar four, if you, bar two, can I, bar seven, and put your ring finger on the third string. Got to get, do it again. Back to the house, four, at two. Now you can either go back down to two, or you can do the A major seventh, which we've done before. It's that C sharp minor, but instead your pointer's up there. Corner by, last of my place, up to seventh fret, six. And we're gonna go six, pluck, pluck, in the middle, two, three, four. One. Okay, so let me play that part for you. So help me if you can. Choose whether to go up or to go down. It's 50-50. Flip a coin, depending on my mood. But there's so much to be done. Though it's kind of fun if you're way down here on the second fret. Much to be done. To give it a little ride and get a fun little, you know, that's kind of fun. Done as you get up to that seventh fret. Okay, now we're going to go. This song kills me to begin with, but showing it over and over, I'm going to be dead by the end of this song. Okay, here we go. So, let's see. Count all the beats. Okay, we're going to bar four, okay? And we're going to stay in the middle, two, three, and four, and six. And we're going to go count all the beats in the. What I was doing there was going one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So one, four, and seven, I'm going to add the bass, and I'm going to make it a little bit of a punch. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And that's the pattern that we're going to do here for the next couple little bits, okay?
Count all the beats in the...
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now go down to the E major 7th. Do it again. So that same pattern. Do it again.
Chase all the clouds from the...
Now we're going to go C sharp.
Chase the clouds from...
That pick was... Bass 3, twin, basses 5, 5, 3, twins 3, 5, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so
chase all the clouds from the sky.
Reach up and grab 6, my pinky gets locked. 8, major 7,
back to the days of Christopher Robin.
So I went bass 3, twins 3, bass 1, 2, 3. I blew this even worse in the intro. Then you start in the second verse. Let me break that little thing down for it. It's really fun. So,
back to the days of Christopher Robin and Pooh.
Pick, do the fourth string open. First string, what is that? 9th fret. 2nd string, 10th fret, and pluck 1 and 2 together twice. 4, pause, twins, twins, pause, slide down to the 5th fret, both of them together in the 5th fret, and pluck them again. Okay, so. And then you're going to do your E major 7th, what did I call that? E suspended 4th? E sus 4, that's it. So it's 3, 4, 5 on the 2nd fret. Strum we did in the intro.
Down, down, up, down.
Okay, so let me kind of show you how that lasts, and then we start again. So let's break that down on the 4th fret. So the A major 7th.
Back to the days of Christopher Robin.
Second verse, same as the first. Here we go. Fourth fret.
Sent him to ask of the Alephus there, how to loosen a jar from the nose of a
bend pinky. There we go. There, it gets locked. It's terrible. There, only in this song.
There, so
chorus.
Help me.
Fourth fret, if you second
can.
Seventh, gotta get
back to the house at the
A major 7th
corner by 1. You'd be surprised, there's so much to be done.
Back to 4th fret.
Count all the bees in the hive. Chase all the clouds from the... Chase the clouds from back to the days of Christopher Robin.
Lost my place. This time we're gonna pluck instead of 5, 4, and 3, we're gonna bar all 5. We're gonna leave E open, okay? So we're gonna go down, down, up, down. Okay? That's a perfect lead-in, because now we're gonna go. So that leads us in that note right there. Okay, so now we're gonna, this is a D major 7th, and the chords are here. I've got all these fun little pictures for you. If you don't know these chords, we're on to page 2. Woohoo! Okay, so it's a D major 7th, and this is a little interlude, and we're gonna go. So what did I do there? So I went 1 and 4, 2, 3, 1 and 4, 2, 3, 1 and 4, 2. Do that again. 1 and 4, 2, 3, 1 and 4, 2, 3, 1 and 4, 2. Now a G major 7th, which is, it's got got a picture for you if you don't know it, but it's like a G, but this guy's behind one fret, just your ring finger, but everybody else is in the same. Okay, so we're gonna go same pick, but now our bass note is six. So six and one. Oh, I picked out the screen. Let me see. Okay. Hopefully it doesn't start singing. Okay, here we go. Da, 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 da. Now we're gonna go to a C with a pinky. This is a C2. So we're gonna put a C, play a C, and then pinky on the second string, third fret, underneath your ring, we're gonna go. So what I'm doing there is I'm plucking one, two, and five, three, twins, twins, and at that point I lift up my pinky, three, twins, then lift up your pointer, twins, three. So let me show you again. So I'm not gonna, you're only gonna pluck the fifth string once. Then the pinky comes off and it's just a regular C, then the pointer comes off, okay? So twins, three, twins, lift, twins, three, twins, lift, twins, three. Okay, hopefully you got that. Then you're gonna go to an A sus 4 and you're gonna go. So what I did there is I went 5 and 1, 2, 3, 1, pull it back into a regular A, 5 and 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay, so let me just show you that much. Okay, so this is the interlude. This is the guitar interlude. Sorry. Pretend I didn't make any mistakes. Okay, then you're going to do, what is this, a B minor? B2 minor. So basically what that is, it's a B minor without the tall man on that second string. So I'm just gonna double bar these guys and leave fourth string and third string on the fourth fret. And then I'm gonna add my tall man. So I'm going one, two, and five, three, twins, and put your tall man on the second string and pluck one, two, and five again, pause. One, two, three. Okay, then I'm gonna gratefully let go of everything and just grab the first string on the second fret and pluck. I mean, you could pluck one, two, and three, and six. And I'm gonna just let everybody else ring, but I'm gonna fiddle around with the first string. So what I'm doing there is I'm gonna pluck one, two, three, and six, and then move up to the third fret, and then the fifth fret, back down to the second fret, pause, open two, tall man on the second string, third fret, then open one. Okay, so it's gonna look like this. I'll play it really slowly. Pause. Two, two, one. Then you're gonna reach up on the sixth string, fifth fret. Always throws me, but I love this part. Six, one, two, slide down to the fourth fret. Six, one, two, six, two. Hold on, Sydney. Yeah. Six, one, two, six, one, two, six, two. Okay? Then you're gonna bar this, the whole fourth fret and go six, three, two, three, one, two, three. Slide down to the second fret, do it again. Six, three, two, three, one, two, three, one. And then you're gonna pull it down. You don't really have to pull it down, but you wanna get a good sound on that fifth string because that's your new bass note. And I don't get always a great sound if I'm barring the sixth string. So I'm gonna pull it down and focus on the fifth string, pinch really hard. And I'm gonna pluck one, two, three, and five. I'm gonna slide up to the 12th fret on the first string. It's so fun. And you could just leave it there with your pinky or pointer laying across on top, but I tend to just pull it down. You could do that too, either way, as long as you get a good sound when you hit that again. So I plucked everybody, hit one, slide it, and then hit one again up on the 12th fret. Okay, so that sounds like this. Let me play the whole interlude here. So it helps if you sing, because he's got a little bit more melody than I've got going on. There's a couple places I'm thinking, I should try to figure out a melody there, but not tonight. Here we go. Okay, that's the interlude. Then we come back in the third verse. Now, I just have to tell you, if you don't know the history of this song, at least this is the way it was explained to me. I love this song. Kenny Loggins wrote the first two verses and then literally left us hanging for like 20 years. I remember. We're like, this song is not ended. It's just dangling out there. And he evidently said, I knew that I didn't know the third verse yet. Then he has a son. And suddenly the third verse comes to him, and then he comes back and puts the third verse on like 10 years, 15, 20 years later. It's so cool about it all comes full circle now that he's got his own son holding his own Pooh bear. Ah, I love this song. Okay, so now, and this is the third verse, best verse of all. Well, it's hard to explain how a few precious things. I'm gonna show you something else you can do right there, okay? How a few precious things. Do 5 and 2. Okay, so that's an option. So what I did there was I put my second string on the 5th fret while barring the 4th, pluck 5 and 2, then lift up your ring and hit 2, and then go down, just let go of everybody else and hit the 2nd string, 2nd fret, and then open. So it's gonna go. Or you can go, but you'll hear him do a little walk down. It seemed to follow, then it's hard to jump back in where I lost my place. Yeah, then you're gonna go back to that funky chord, that A major 7. So you're in the middle, 6-4 twins, 4, slide up to your B7th on the 7th fret. In the middle, bass 4, twins 4. Now we're going to do something that I hear him do a couple more places than I'm doing it, but it's really hard and it's really cool. We're going to go to an E, and we're going to, with our thumb, go 6, 5, and then your pointer's now on 4. You're in the middle, okay? So 2, 3, 4, and you're going to go 6, 5, and you're going to pluck 4 and 3 together. 6, 5, 4 and 3 together. Then pluck them again and let go of your tall man and slide from the 1st and 2nd fret up to the 4th and 6th and pluck it again. Whoops. Oh, you don't get to pluck it again. Scrap that. Don't pluck it again. You just have to land there. And then you're going to hit 1 and then go down to the 2nd and 4th fret and hit 1 again. So it's going to sound like this. That took me forever to get, by the way. So if you can't do it right away, don't feel bad. Okay, I'll do it again really slowly. 6, 5, 4, and 3 together. Pluck them again and slide up to 4 and 6. 1, down to 2 and 4. 1. Not fun. Well, then go back to the beginning. When it's all said and done, I was watching my son. Now we're going to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just walk right up and just kind of hold it. Let that in the air. So he's in the air. He's watching his son sleeping with his own Pooh bear cuddled up. Okay? Sitting there with my bear by his side. Okay? Now we're going to go to the C sharp minor 4th fret. So I tucked him in. I kissed him. I just did that twice. You could alternate. Bar 4, and as I was going, I could swear that old man whispered, voice, F sharp, boy, welcome, slide up, unlock pinky, welcome home, believe me. We're going to go to a key change. into G. Fortunately, it's a good key change. We can do it. Sometimes they get crazy on me. Okay, so we're going to go to a G. Believe me. Bass three. What is bugging me? You. Probably it. Ugh. Okay. That's been bugging me the whole song. So sorry. Believe me. B minor if you. A minor seventh, which is just second string first fret. Tall man fourth string second fret. Can I? D seventh. Finally come. B minor. Back to that. I'm doing just bass three, twin three, bass three, twin three, or in the middle. No, I think I've been out of the middle this whole time. Back to the E minor, house at Pooh, A minor, quarter by D6. So that's a D7th without the ring finger. And then we're going to go 1, 2, and 4, 3, put your ring finger down, twins, 3. Okay, then just take your ring finger, slide them up one fret to the 3rd fret, 1st string. Pluck six and one, two, three, one, and then a B minor, and then a C, and then a D. And again, you could do that same thing right there if you want to. Okay, so let me show you, let me put in the words with that. Okay, this is new, because remember, I learned this song before he put the ending on it, and so I don't have this part memorized. This is, you know, recent. The other stuff I've been playing for 20 years and just dangling on the ending, and now I really have to really watch this part closely because I don't have it memorized, and you can't memorize things after 30. It's just impossible. So I've concluded. Okay, here we go. So believe me, B minor if you, A minor seventh, can I, D seventh, finally come, B minor back to the E minor, house at the A minor, corner by D six, and then D seven. Pinky up or ring finger up on the first string. What do you know? B minor, no, there's so. And I went bass five and you could do a twins three or five and one, two, three, one. What do you know? There's so. I like that. Five and one, two, three, one. Much to be. Back to probably the bass three twins, you're on that C. That much to be done. Or just a straight D. Done. Change it every time. B minor. Count all the B's in dance. So that same 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Stressing 1, 4, and 7 that we did before with our bass note is 5 now on the B minor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do it again. Chase all the clouds from there. So we did count all the B's. Chase all the clouds from above. Now we're gonna go up to our, it's got late. Okay, 7th fret, 6th string, 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, so we're gonna pluck those guys, and then 1, slide down 2 frets, but shift your grip on those last 2, so you're now going 1st string, 3rd string, not it. Hold on. Oh, it's this position. Sorry. First string, and then these guys are second and third string on the 7th fret. So pluck everybody again, then hit 6. So we've gone pluck 6, pluck 6. Okay? Then you're going to slide down 2 more frets and kind of do a 1-3-2 position. Now I'm on the 3rd fret, 4th fret, and 5th. 1st string, 3rd fret, tall man on the 3rd string, 4th fret, and ring finger on the 2nd string, 5th fret. And pluck it again, then hit 1, slide down just 1 fret this time and shift those 2 back to stair steps. So it's 1, 2, 3. That's where we started. 1, 2, 3 up on the 7th. Now we're going to be down on the 2nd. And then hit 6 again. So it's going to sound like this. Chase the clouds. practice that to get faster. Chase the clouds from. One more time. Chase the clouds from back to. And then go right to a C. And then we're going to go 5 and 1. Back to that. So I'm going to go 5 and 1, 2, 3, 1.
Back to that days of.
And that's a D. So 4 and 1. 4 and 1, 2, 3, 1. And then I'm assuming it's a B minor, but I've lost my place. Yes.
Christopher.
Same thing. 5 and 1, 2, 3, 1. E minor. 6. 6 and 1, 2, 3, 1.
Robin.
Okay.
Back to the days of Christopher Robin.
And repeat it.
Back to the ways of Christopher Robin.
Now we're going to go.
Back to the.
So that was on a C, 5 and 1, 2, 3, D. Quick switch to D, 4 and 1, 2, 3, E minor. Technically, you don't need anything there as long as you don't hit 4 and 5. Okay, but now you need it, so just grab it. So you're gonna go poo, 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 poo. So poo, and that's kind of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it says 8 low strums. Technically, I guess you could go. Leave the 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then you're gonna, and I'm focusing on the bottom 3 or 4 strings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. C. No, we're gonna keep the hit. We're gonna keep strumming. So that was on C. I do 4, focusing again on the bottom strings. 1, 2, 3, 4. D. Now you can't hit 6 really on a D, so kind of go into the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4, E minor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, focus on 1, 4, and 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. C. Now we're going to go up to the 7th and 8th fret, 5th and 2nd string. So 5th string, 7th fret, 2nd string, 8th fret. So plucking 5 and 2. Then slide to the 5th and 7th frets. Now 3 and 5, and then 2 and 3. Okay, so that's going to... So it's kind of a pluck, pause, quick, quick, pause, pluck, pause, and then you're going to go like you're going to grab a D7th, but right now you could... Yeah, you could totally grab it. You could totally grab a D7th there. So I'm plucking 5 and 2, 3, and then a regular D. I'm going to pluck 1, 2, 3, and 4 all together. And then I'm going to, my ring finger's right there. Leave them there. Put your pinky on underneath and grab a G5 and just give me one strum. And that's the song. Okay, let me do that last little part. I'm going to do the key change. Okay, because that's the part that's different from all this. Okay.
Believe me if you can.
Come on, I can do this. Oh man, I blew that thing. Let me try that again.